Oh, Can you hear the angels sing? birthday. It's when we remember that Jesus came into this world as a baby.
That's right. An evergreen tree has an ever-appropriate name. It is evergreen, always green. It does not become dormant in the winter as other trees do. The color green represents new life, and the needles of the evergreen always point up heavenward. It symbolizes our everlasting life with Jesus Christ. We should be as the evergreen tree, always full of life, never becoming dormant in our life with Jesus Christ. And our arms are always lifted heavenward.
The bread of God is the one who comes down from heaven. He gives life to the world. John 6:33.
I didn't realize.
Well, I didn't either.
I just thought it was a tree.
Yeah, I didn't know that it meant something. What does this other stuff mean?
How about the ornaments?
Ornaments are used to decorate Christmas trees each and every year. People look at the perfect ones to fit on their tree. Our Christmas tree just would not seem complete without our ornaments. Ornaments can symbolize the blessings in our lives. Our lives just would not be complete without God's blessings. Everything that we have is due to God loving us so much that He wanted to shower us with His blessings. Just as the ornaments are on the tree, they're in different shapes and sizes. Blessings are all different as well. God picks the chosen and chooses each and every one of the blessings so that you and I will be just right. Next time you decorate your tree, as soon as you put up each ornament, think of a blessing that God has given you. I think you'll find that you'll run out of ornaments before you can run out of blessings.
Every man shall give as he is able, according to the blessing of the Lord your God that He has given you. Deuteronomy 16:17.
Blessings.
We have so many blessings.
We have our home and our family.
It's hard to think of all the blessings that God has given us.
Okay, I guess it's not so bad. And it does look nice.
Oh, but there's so much more. How about we talk about the lights and candles?
Lights and candles are used to give light. When a room is full of darkness, it is dark. But if you light a single match in a dark room, the room is light. There may be more darkness, but the light overpowers it. We are that light. We are a single light in a dark world. We must share our light with the world so that the light increases.
You are the light of the world. A city set on a hill cannot be hidden, nor do people light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a stand. And it gives light to all in the house. Matthew 5:14-15.
I love the lights.
They're so pretty.
Let's put more lights on.
I never knew.
I guess I never looked like we are the lights of God.
Exactly. Now, let's put bells on the tree.
The bell rings out to guide the lost sheep back to the fold, signifying that all are precious in the eyes of the Lord. Jesus is our shepherd, and He laid down His life for us so that we may spend eternity with Him in heaven. He is calling us to follow Him through His word. Are you going to listen?
If a man has 100 sheep and one of them has gone astray, does he not leave the 99 in the mountains and go in search of the one that went astray? Matthew 18:12. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. John 10:11.
The bells sound so beautiful.
I just love to listen to them.
Jesus is our shepherd.
You are his sheep.
You would go looking for me.
Who likes candy canes?
Me.
Let's put those on next.
The candy cane symbolizes many things. If you hold it upright, it looks like the shepherd's crook. The shepherds were some of the few people who were able to see baby Jesus in Bethlehem. If you turn the candy cane upside down, it looks like a J. Jesus starts with the letter J. The colors of the candy cane are also symbolic. The red represents the blood that Jesus shed on the cross, while the white represents the purity of Jesus. There are candy canes with three small stripes running around it. These stripes symbolize the Trinity, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Who knew that these delicious, simple candies were so profoundly symbolic for our Lord Jesus Christ and His simple birth?
And she will bring forth a son, and you shall call His name Jesus, for He will save His people from their sins. Matthew 1:21.
These are delicious.
I love this part of Christmas.
It means so many things.
There seems to be the reason why we do everything that we do.
I can see all the stuff has meaning.
I'm so glad that you're changing your mind about some of these things. I have some stars to put onto the tree next.
The star is a heavenly sign of prophecy, fulfilled ages ago, the shining hope for all mankind. The star led the wise men to find baby Jesus. These wise men traveled many miles following a star in the sky. The star was their guiding light to the Savior. God was the wise men's travel agent of sorts, leading them to the greatest destination in the land, the Savior. We now have his word as our guiding light, to lead us to be with him in heaven. Are you going to follow him?
And behold, the star which had seen in the east went before them, till it came and set over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. Matthew 2:9b-10.
That is what the star means, but I have a song that can explain it even further.
The berries symbolize the blood he shed for us. He endured criticism, excruciating pain, and embarrassment all for you and I. The next time you see a decoration with holly on it, remember what was done for you so that he could spend eternity with you. I know that I will.
And twisting together a crown of thorns, they put it on his head and put a reed in his right hand. And kneeling before him, they mocked him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews." Matthew 27:23.
That's amazing what he did for us.
It makes me feel blessed to know him.
He went through all that for me.
He came to this earth in order to die for me and you.
That's a quite an amazing thing to think about during this Christmas season.
That leads us to the wreath that will hang on the door.
The wreath has its evergreen branches bent in a circle so that the ends touch, having no beginning or end. Just as there is no beginning or end to Jesus' eternal love for us. Just as the wreath looks the same throughout and does not seem to change, so he will always be the same.
Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Hebrews 13:8.
I just love how it looks on our door.
Yes, it really finishes off the look of the room.
It's nice to know that he will never change.
I didn't realize that it had a meaning.
That's a great reminder. Even though we grow and change, he'll always be right.
Well, you'll be surprised then.
These days, the world has forgotten the reason for Christmas. Most people seem to think that getting presents is the greatest thing about Christmas. Other people think that presents have nothing to do with Christmas. Well, they're both wrong. The wise men came to visit Jesus as a young child and gave him presents. They gave him gold, frankincense, and myrrh. They offered him gold as king, paying him tribute. Frankincense as God, for they honored God with the smoke of incense. And myrrh as the man that should die. For the myrrh was used in embalming dead bodies. These wise men, saw this child and knew that he is king, is God, and that he would die for the sins of the world. How can anyone, with the knowledge that we have now, not believe?
The wise men went to the house. There they saw the child with his mother Mary. They bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures. They gave him gold, incense, and myrrh. Matthew 2:11.
I love to get presents.
I didn't know that was the reason we give gifts.
But Jesus is really the greatest gift of all.
Truly is.
Christians together in his love. We may not be of the same family, but we are all of the family of God. Jesus is the ribbon that binds us together.
And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Colossians 3:14.
I just thought the wrappings were to hide the presents inside.
Yeah, I never thought about them having their own meaning.
There is really a lot to think about.
I guess I'll have to look at things.
That's for sure. I never knew that all this stuff happened.
Well, people do get a little crazy with the stuff of Christmas. The parties, the gift giving, the busyness of the Christmas season. What we need to do is slow down and enjoy every moment by remembering the true meaning of Christmas.
Now, who wants a cookie?
Me!
I know there's not a meaning in a cookie.
You'd be surprised.
Making cookies is a favorite pastime for most families during the Christmas season. Cookie cutters are used to turn ordinary dough into edible masterpieces. God doesn't use cookie cutters when he creates each one of us. He makes every one of us so special and unique that he would have to break the mold after just one use. He is the potter and we are his clay. He wants to mold us into his masterpieces. We only need to be moldable and willing to lead, to follow his lead.
Behold, like the clay in the potter's hand, so are you in my hand, O house of Israel. Jeremiah 18:6.
Thank you.